So a little bit on top of my forehead, bridge of the nose, and then on my chin, my earlobe, on my breast implants, a little bit on my ass. I visited a plastic surgeon and a skin dermatologist and I was so scared. By the way, did I even tell you the story of how Lily Lashes blocked me on Instagram? Hello sluts, I'm so gonna get demonetized sometime. Anyway, today I'm actually just doing a trying on new makeup products kind of a video. I have a bunch of new items that I've purchased throughout like the holidays, as well as a bunch of PR items were sent to me. So yeah, I wanted to try all of them out. You can just click off. I know it's really boring, like it's just me yapping, talking shit, panicking, crying, screaming about my skin. And also Lily Lashes, they blocked me on Instagram, so you're just gonna see a lot of that in this video. Probably watch this when you're pooping, taking a shower, eating, just play me in the background. But yeah, let's get started. But before you do, please subscribe, like, also click the notification bell. Who is tired of YouTubers saying this every time? But it has to be done. There's always some newbie who's like, where is the subscription box? I can't find it. So that's why I do it. Trust me, it's annoying to say it every single video. So I'm gonna shut the f up and yeah, enjoy. Before I start my video, I do wanna say I use the Laneige Special Care Lip Sleeping Mask Berry. So this is the one that I use. And this is like so expensive, by the way. It's, I think, $20, which is mind-blowing to me. And I've used like 1/4 of it, if you can see. So for moisturizer, I have used up the Eucerin Dry Skin Replenishing Face Cream 5% Urea. This is how it looks. And you can see I have finished up, like, there's nothing left in this. So Sigma sent me this in their PR list, and this is their skincare brush set. It's for skin pampering, so freaking cute. It's like all holo-ish. Okay, I swear to God, Sigma is the only brand which comes up with these ideas. Like, who thought that you need a brush for moisturizer? So this is a brush that you use for your face mask. It's for clay or mud mask, and I've destroyed a lot of my makeup brushes, which is not cute. So this is the brush for serums. Do I have a serum that I want to try out? And this is for moisturizer. This is for gel masks, and this is for eye cream. And oh, there's one more. This is their spatula. I think it's just to like mix in foundation or concealer, like if you're like putting on someone's face, like a clientele, you know. So this is the one for moisturizer. I'm just gonna go in. The next thing I want to go in is the Claire's Vitamin C oil, and I'm going to use my serum brush to apply this on my face. Let's see how this works out. I'm just gonna apply, like, I apply very little of vitamin C because I don't like too much oil. So once I'm done with that, I'm going in with the Neutrogena Hydra Boost. I'm gonna use this as my eye cream using their eye cream brush. I have horrible under eye circles, so this, hopefully it does help. Ooh, this is really moisturizing. Yeah, I like that. As I'm crying, this is me literally with my first ex. I think I dated this dumbass in 8th grade, and oh my god, this is literally me. Anyways. Shit, there's one more. That's the reason I threw it off. Why was it heavy? We have the clay mask that I can't be using today. I'm not doing clay masks today. But yeah, that's the end, children. So now finally, we are moving on to the face. Today, I'm going to try out this sample piece. This is like, I don't know, 3 years old. To all I know, there could be lizards coming out of this. But you know, what is life without taking risks? There's literally nothing. Why can't I? Ew, it's so, can you see this? It's like my boogers from 6th grade. Can you see this? Should I put this on my face? I'm kind of worried now. Ooh, oh my god, this actually made my pores go away. This is crazy. It actually smoothed my skin. So I'm just gonna dig in. Okay, I really shat on this primer, but I really freaking like it. This is crazy, and it's also like really mattifying. What is this? It's their Beauty Amplifier Smoothing Primer, and yes, it does smooth the shit out of my skin. Okay, I love this primer. I'm so getting this primer. Look at this. Did you just see how matte? Oh, isn't this smooth than how it was before? Okay, so now we're going on to some foundation. So for foundation, I picked up the LA Girl Pro Matte Foundation. You guys saw that haul that I just picked it up. So I'm just gonna apply this all over my face. Yeah. Okay, I hope this matches me, or else I'll have to fix it with some concealer. If you follow me on my Instagram, you know that I spoke about how I wanted to get my microblading done. I was really, really pumped, really excited, and I have honestly no eyebrows, and microblading exists, which is amazing. But I just found out that I'm a fucking pussy ass bitch, and I can't just you know, I can't just go and get shit injected into my eyeballs. Okay, I'm really exaggerating. It's not really your eyeballs, but you know, oh my god, like, it's pretty much like tattooing, and that's the reason I have no tattoos on my body, because I cannot stand those kind of needles and the pain. And like, okay, if microblading was like push a button, get your shit done, get the fuck out of here, then I would fucking do it. But it's literally 5,000 literally, I don't know, 50 needles per hour, 20 needles per hour, 70 needles per hour, I don't know. But it's just a lot of needles and a lot of cutting and crafting, which I don't like. Jeez, it's 2019. There are still pussy ass bitches existing on this planet. Can we have some kind of technology development for like pain-free procedures? By now, I would expect it to be like press a button and get a baby. Like, I remember I told my mom when I was a baby that I would never get pregs. And I'm 21 now and I still stand by it. Like, I can't. Childbirth is so fucking scary. I'm so sorry if you're pregnant and you're watching this. You're good, sweetie. You're gonna do great. I hope, fingers crossed, by the time I'm pregnant or like it's 2030 or something, there's like an option for like pussy ass bitches. I'll pay extra if I have to. But yeah, that's the reason I haven't got microblading, because I backed out. Like, I met with my microblading artist, if you want to call it that. It's really, really good, her work. So I agreed to it, but now I'm the one who's like backing out. Okay, so for concealer, I'm using the Revolution Conceal and Define. This is in the shade C10.5. Place this concealer under my eye. Ooh, wow, the concealer is really smooth. I love it. It also smells really nicely weird. So I'm gonna blend out my concealer with my sponge. I really want my eyebrows to be done. Also, I forgot to mention like the main part where I have like keloid prone skin. If you don't know what keloid is, I would probably suggest googling it, but don't fucking do it, you're gonna die. It's so disgusting. And I have that on my ear, and I have that kind of skin type, I would say. And I have it on my ear, I have one on my leg. Okay, so far, I really like the concealer. I feel like it covered up pretty much everything except like this pimple zit that's gonna form and burst on my birthday. Oh no, I was supposed to contour my face. Can I still do that? So I'm using the Sister Cosmetics HD Concealer in the shade Brownie, and it's a really, really pretty contour shade. So I had like a weird acne spot on my face, and it was so ugly, and it didn't even look like acne. It looked like a weird bulbous, softy, skinny looking pimple on my face. And if you didn't know, keloid looks like that in the beginning, and then it forms into this really, really ugly monster. Keloid is non-curable, not curable, uncurable, anti-curable, just not curable, okay? And it actually gets me so depressed and sad when I think about this, because I have it on my ear and it's gonna grow till the day I die. It's gonna keep growing forever. It's gonna grow when I'm married, when I'm pregnant, I have 50 grandkids. It's probably gonna grow when I'm on my funeral bed, in the coffin, under the damn graveyard. It's so bad, I hate it, I hate him. If keloid was a human being, I'm gonna find him and punch him in the face. God, I hate keloid so much. A very mini story to what and how keloids form. My skin, take a knife, you cut it, the wound is gonna heal, it might form a keloid. That is the easiest definition to explain to you what keloid is. So you can think of how crazy this is, because how, like, any kind of cut that I get on my hand, my leg, I have to be very careful. If it doesn't heal properly, I get a fucking keloid. I love my life, it's amazing. So, you know, I'm chopping up like carrots, cucumbers, or whatever the fuck. If I chop my finger off, I have to be very careful, and hopefully it doesn't form into a keloid. Okay, I'm gonna dust off the powder now. It's baking for so long. I think I was on the bike with my cousin brother back when I was in 11th grade or 10th grade. We got into a horrible accident. The bike kind of skid and we fell on the other side of the road. Thank God there was like no trucks on the other side. Like, thank the Lord, because I wouldn't be alive right now if there was like a vehicle on the other side. We literally flipped over to the other side of the road, like we both flat, and I woke up and I'm like, what the f-? Like, what is going on? My leg was bleeding, like my knees were bleeding. My cousin brother was fine. My arms, like here I have a keloid, it's flat, it's not growing. My leg, my knee, there's one growing currently, so it's I hate it so much. Okay, I'm gonna move on to the shadow now, because I'm gonna just keep talking. Okay, I'm jumping on to my eyes now. I absolutely hate it, like, good Lord. So yes, till this day, what, it's been 5-6 years and the keloid is still on my leg and it doesn't go, and it's really ugly. You can't see it on camera, you can see it if you really close up close. So I really hate the keloid. So now you guys know what keloid is, okay? It's horrible. So there are like few ways you can prevent it from growing, and that's steroid injections, which is really bad, and also like removing it off. You can cut the keloid off and throw it off. So this is my hand, I get a cut, a keloid forms. Now here's the thing, keloid forms because if there's some sort of trauma to your skin, like any kind of cuts, any burns, if there's a keloid and I cut the keloid, I'm doing the same thing again, like I'm creating more trauma to my skin. So what happens is the keloid grows twice the size it was before. So it's gonna be like 2 times bigger, and that's what happened to my ears. You guys, I pierced my ears. my ear here. Till this year, I have a fucking killer on my ear. We got it removed and then it grew back again. So that is so exciting. Love my life. Do you love your life? Because I do. And I have been going every single, I think, 2-3 weeks to a clinic to visit the doctor to get it like injected. I get steroid injections here. Okay, before I continue with the story, I'm using my Juvia's eyeshadow palette. This is the Warrior 2 by Juvia's eyeshadow palette. I purchased a bunch of the shadow palettes off their website. I found out that they were black owned and you know I had to support their asses. This is the new one that I got. They are the world's most pigmented shadows out here. Like if you're a woman of color struggling to find like a good shadow for your eyes, I would highly suggest looking into Juvia's eyeshadows. So yeah, back to the story. Where was I? Back to the pimple story. So I had like a weird pimple growing on here and I was so freaked out. You have no idea. I started crying. It was the day I had to catch the flight to India and I was like tearing up, crying. I drove off at 6 a.m. I woke up. I'm like, what is this? Like, why is my face looking like this? I drove off to the plastic surgeon. And I visited a plastic surgeon and a skin dermatologist. I visited like 5-6 doctors because I was so scared. The thing is that the consultation is not expensive because my mom works in the medical field. So for me, all the medical services are kind of free. So I can like do whatever the fuck I want to. I can get like a new face and like delete my YouTube channel and no one's gonna know. It's gonna be free as well. Like, that's amazing. Thank you, mom. Okay, then I'm using the shadow Kana. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce that. So yeah, I did visit a plastic surgeon, skin dermatologist. At one point, I think I went to a dentist asking about my acne. I was this much of a pussy. So I did visit all of them and I did ask them like, okay, be honest, like don't do this to kiss my ass. There's a keloid growing on my face, isn't it? Because if it's growing on my face, I'm pretty busted. Mainly because I'm doing makeup and it's just gonna keep growing and growing. You know what I mean? Keloid looks really, really ugly, but that's the reason like people get it removed. It's on their chest or breast, on their cheeks. But I don't care about it being ugly. If it's on my face, and if it's ugly, I'm okay with it. But my problem is it's just gonna keep growing, you know? And I don't know when it's gonna stop or like what's gonna happen. They all told me it's not. The skin dermatologist, but he suggested like, hey, do you want me to just put steroid on the acne spot just to make you happy? Like, I'll do it if you want me to because I know you're terrified. And I was like, no, I don't know what to do. And he was like, listen, just give it a week. Like, give it a week. I'm like, no, it's been a month. Like, can you imagine? This acne thing was sitting on my face for a month. And it's not acne on my face and it's like a bubble. So that's why I was really freaked out. But everyone told me to calm down and I was really overthinking it. Was I really though? Was I really? So right now it's Jan 25th as I'm filming this. So that means it's been exactly 2.5 months. And now the bubble thing popped off. Who's pimple blast after 2.5 months? But yeah, fun, happy story. I do not have keloids on my face. Nothing is growing, so I'm kind of happy about it. Next shadow is the Kufuru shadow I'm gonna dip into. It's a bit darker and I'm just gonna apply this all over my lids. And then I'm dipping it into the black shadow, just straight like this. And then I'm kind of lining my lash line. The next palette I'm using is the Celestial palette from Ironic. They sent this to me and I believe the owners are brown, so you know I had to support them. So this is their glitter palette and I haven't used them. They are so beautiful, so I decided to use it for this tutorial. So for this, you really don't require any kind of glue. Oh wow, look at Oh wow. I love this. So the inner corners, I'm gonna make that really pigmented. And then as we bring it out, we kind of spread it, like spread around. So for the liner, I'm using the NYX Professional Makeup Matte Liquid Liner. It's like the one that everyone seems to like. So yeah, I'm just gonna apply liner. Oh hell no! Technical difficulties, ladies. Just hold on tight. This is like me trying to fix something and then becomes like 7 times bigger. I'm not even kidding. Both the liners are like honestly facing like one direction to my ex's house and this is like the different direction to my other ex's house. This is insane. How do people do liners? It's fine. It's okay. I don't want any hate comments. I'm gonna go into the lashes. It's gonna save the look. Lily lashes in the style of Mink Hollywood. I have the Lily lashes that I did try on. I like it. It's not bad. It's really uncomfortable in my opinion. I don't know how people wear it. it is poking me every side, left, right corner. So that's one thing I really don't like about the Lily Lashes. Maybe it's just the Miami one, but I'm gonna give this a try. Also, I did pick up the Duo Lash Glue. Now, if you're a lashaholic like me, I would highly recommend getting this lash glue. And the reason being that it has the one white side and the one black side. There are some looks I don't mind the black. When I have no liner on, this is going to mimic that liner effect. But most of the time, I do want to have white. So sometimes it's black, sometimes it's white. Again, I'm really indecisive. So these are how the Hollywood lashes look. They're pretty fluffy. They're not natural in any way, shape, or form. Oh my god, I can't open this. Dad, is my dad home? God damn it. I opened it. I opened this by myself. This happens like once in 10 months. I actually opened something without asking a dude's help. Wow, props to me. Okay, so this is how it looks. It's really tiny and small. So it is drying and this dries pretty quick, just like maybe 20 seconds. The Miami lashes are so overhyped. That's the reason I got it, but I think I like it. By the way, did I even tell you the story of how Lily Lashes blocked me on Instagram? So fun story, I was actually, so I purchased Miami lashes from them, like from the brand, like Lily Miami Lashes. And surprisingly enough, the order didn't come through. Like it didn't make it to my housey. And there was some problem with my delivery address, which is so weird because all my life, like even right now, all the items I purchased here was to the same address. They told me the address doesn't exist and it's like a wrong address. And I told them it's the right address. They didn't believe me. And what they did is that they just decided not to give me the product. So then I had to email them and then they still did not reply to me. They were like, we'll call you. And I'm like, I stay in Dubai. Like, how are you gonna call me? Okay, wait, let me just do my blush and contour as I'm telling you the story. Okay, so for bronzer, I'm using the shadow Yara, which is like a really neutral tone bronzer. So yeah, I, you know, emailed them and they were like, oh my god, I didn't blend my contour on my jaw. This is so embarrassing. But they were just ignoring me. They weren't replying to me at all. So I got really, really mad. At one point, they did call me from the US. Like I got a US number calling me. So I was like, oh, okay, it's them. Like, okay, I'll pick it up. I pick up the call and there's no one talking on the phone. And this happened like 7 times. So as a customer, I was like just getting annoyed because my order wasn't coming through. And I don't know, it was just a huge mess. So I left a comment on one of their posts saying that, hey, you guys haven't replied to me. Like, where is my order? You guys have to give my money, blah, blah, blah. The money was $80 to $70. It wasn't $10, I won't give a shit, but there was a lot of money, so I was losing my mind. I just wanted my damn lashes. So they still didn't reply to me, and then finally they saw my comment, they deleted my comment, and then they come up to my DMs and they're like, hey, text us like your order number and we'll help you out with it. Okay, moving on to blush, I really like the shade Tall. Finally, they refunded the money to me and they told me, I'm sorry, we cannot send you the package because there's something wrong with like the whole delivery, whatever. Funny thing is that someone from like, what is it called? Someone from the Instagram PR team page, they saw like my DM messages. I'm like, you guys are horrible. Where are my lashes? Where are my money? You guys are a scam. They saw that message and then they blocked me on Instagram. So that's how I got blocked by Lily Lashes. So I do take up my hair and then I go with a shadow brush inside my hairline. You want to do this so you don't have that weird white line going on, you know? So now moving on to the lips. I'm going to be using the NYX Cosmetics Urban Cafe lip liner. And then I'm also topping it up with Lime Crime Shroom Liquid Lipstick. Guys, I hate doing this because honestly, I can never find a perfect nude for my skin tone. I'm always like mixing 7 to 8 lipsticks and lip liners and lipsticks and it is so exhausting. If I ever launch a brand with liquid lipsticks, like just nude stuff for brown skin, would you buy it? That would be insane, right? I have like the best combinations in mind, like the best. So yeah, this is the finished lip look. I really like this lip look. I always have like a combination that I keep going back to, so I write it down on my phone. Now if I go out and someone asks me, what do I have on my lips? So I'll have to be like, 7 products, sweetheart. Do you want another list? You know, it's so hard to get me some new mauve pink lipsticks for my skin. Now finally, I do want to apply some highlighter. The one that I've been using is the Dose of Colors Daisy and Katie Chasing the Sun highlighter. I have like a fat ass pimple sitting here and I'm trying to avoid it. It's like the fat Indian auntie in like weddings that I don't want and no one invited her but she still comes and everyone's just avoiding her. That's this fucking pimple. My birthday is like, what, this week. I hope the pimple goes away by then. Because I want my face to be flawless the day I turn 21. This highlighter is buttered. I swear it's the best thing ever I've got last year. Like, oh, I love this. So a little bit on top of my forehead, a little on the bridge of the nose, a little bit on the nosy, and then on my chin. And then also I love doing my collarbones. A little bit on my breast implants, a little bit on my earlobe as well, a little bit on my ass. I'm kidding. But yep, this is the finished look. I have the Morphe Continue Setting Mist left to spray on my face. This is the pretty new, I think I've used this probably just 5 to 6 times by now, but I have to say I got this because of Kathleen Lights on YouTube. She's amazing. I swear she's one of the most honest and down-to-earth human beings I watch. Aquarius, obviously, duh, she's amazing. And she's always honest, and whenever she recommends something and I go out and I purchase it, I swear they've always been spot on. Whenever she describes a flavor or like a product and what it does to you and what's the con, what's the pros, like, it's the same thing that I noticed too. So that says that she's pretty honest. So she recommended this for like super dry skin. I don't have dry skin, but it apparently has this really smooth like mist, like, don't want to waste it. Might as well get my toes into it. But yeah, I don't want to waste the spray. But she recommended this because of the mist. It's very fine. Like when you put it on your face, it kind of melts your makeup into your skin and you can't even feel the mist. So yeah, this is the finished look. I hope you really like how the video turned out. This has been a super long video. I've been filming since 4 PM and it's like really dark out now. Also do leave a comment on what you want to see next. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys in my next video.